Hello students, namaste, how are you all? Hope all of you are well. Today is the last online class. Hope all of you are feeling well, but from now we don't have to study, right? But actually, whatever the efforts we have done for you, it should not go waste. Whatever the question answers, whatever the chapter explanation we have done through the online, you must watch these videos again and again. So what will happen, as you will get the concept, you will be able to write all the chapters question answers. Since all the five chapters I have given you question answers, means total first to fourth already I have given you. Today I will give you the chapter number 6, physical and chemical changes question answers, and I request you all to write question answers of all these chapters, whatever I had explained. If you have not written, then just open my channel, go through the playlist option. In the playlist you will search class 7 science. So open that class 7 science playlist, you will get each and every video whatever I have taught to you. So please, there is an humble request that you should write the question answers in your notebook, because you should utilize the time, whatever the time you have got it. Either I have given you MCQ, fill in the blanks, question answers, as I had informed you many times to take a screenshot. So whatever I have said to you, please do that and write the question answers in your notebook with pen. So as the school reopens, that time you will not get a lot of burden to do at once. So that's why I am requesting you all to write question answers in the notebook. So let's start the last video, class 7 science, chapter number 6, physical and chemical changes, question answers. Let's start. So as we are moving towards, first of all, MCQ, you can just see the questions of MCQ. What we have to do, you have to just take a screenshot of this. See, I will give you each and every answers also. First of all, you have to write this MCQ in your notebook. So as you have seen, there are total 6 MCQ. First, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. Now can we move towards the next? Since you can just take this MCQ shortcuts or screenshots. As you have taken the screenshot, now we will move towards the next MCQs, right? Now you can take the screenshot of 7th, 8th, 9th, this MCQ. 7, 8 you have taken a screenshot. Now we are moving towards the 9th and 10th MCQ, right? So you can see here there are two MCQ more, 9th and 10th. So all of you have taken a screenshot. So now can we move ahead for the fill in the blanks type question? So you can just see, take each and every screenshot, because you have to write these questions in your notebook, okay? So you can see here fill in the blanks type questions. So total this side 6 questions are there. You can take this 6 question screenshot, and here also 6 short questions are there, right? So you can take this screenshot of this short questions also, okay? So now the rest, fill in the blanks, can we move? Have you taken the screenshot? Okay, very good. So now we are moving the next fill in the blanks and true or false type questions. So here you can see the rest fill in the blanks, 7, 8 is given, right? Till 6, that side it was given, and here you can see the 5 true or false are also given. So you can take a screenshot of this true or false also, and after then we are moving towards the next true or false question. Till 5 you have already taken. So total there are 10 true or false type questions. So 4 to 10 you can take a screenshot, and after then the small or short answer type questions, already you have taken screenshot of this 6 question. If you have not taken, then please take the screenshot of this 6 questions. Have you taken it? So now can we move for the rest short and long question answers? Okay, so now as we are moving for the long question answers and the rest of the shorts, here you can see the total 7, 8, here total 8 short question answers are there, and you can see here little bit. Are you able to see? Not able to see? Wait, don't worry. Now, yeah. So 7, 8, take a screenshot. Now take a screenshot of this long question answers. 3 this side is there. 3, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay? So now come 4 to 9. 3, 1, 2, 3 long question answers. Screenshot you have taken. Now we are moving towards the 4 to 9 question answers of long. Right? All of you have taken this 9 question answers. Now shall we move towards the question answers answer part? Sure. So now you can take the screenshot of answers. Here you can see exercise, all the first one is MCQ, right? So there were total 10 MCQs. The smallest particle of compound that can exist in nature, the B option was molecule. Similarly, if we move towards the 10th question, the browning of the cut surface of fruit is similar to rusting. So here all the 10 MCQ answers are there, and after then fill in the blanks are there. Total there are 118 elements known till now. You can see, fill in the blanks. B part is fill in the blanks till the 8th option is copper sulfate. Now we are talking about the C part, true or false. There are 10 true or false. It starts from first, that is true, and the 10th one is false. Now we are moving towards the short question answers. You can see, what is an element? You can just take a screenshot of this question answers. As you take a screenshot, first of all, I am reading all the 8 questions. You can see here, what is an element? Define an atom and molecule. What is the formula of nitric acid? Name the atoms present in one molecule of nitric acid. Means all these question answers already you have taken a screenshot. So first of all, can you tell me what is an element? The element is a substance that cannot be split into simpler substances by chemical method. Second one is define an atom and a molecule. The smallest particle of an element that retains the property of the element is called an atom. Molecules are the smallest particle of the elements and compounds that can exist independently in nature, molecules and made of atoms. Next one is, third question is, how many atoms of, what is the formula of nitric acid? HNO3 is the formula of nitric acid. The atoms present in one mole of nitric acids are hydrogen, nitrogen and oxygen. 3 moles of oxygen means 3 atoms of oxygen, 1 atom of hydrogen and 1 atom of nitrogen. Now the fourth one, compound A reacts with compound B to form compound C. What does the change react? So here it's very easy. This is a chemical change because after the reaction, the new product is formed. So that's why it is a chemical change. A plus B is equal to C. Fifth question, what compounds do this formula represent? H2O is known as water, CO2 carbon dioxide, CuSO4 copper sulfate, NaHCO3 sodium bicarbonate. Got it? Now we are moving towards the question number 6. What is crystallization and what is it used for? Crystallization is the process of separating out a solid from its solution as crystals, and this process is used to get pure crystals of certain substances. Seventh one, write the chemical equation in words. Here already about the rusting of iron, you can see 7th and 8th both. So Fe plus CuSO4 is equal to Cu plus FeSO4. Iron plus copper sulfate is equal to copper plus iron sulfate, because iron is more reactive than copper. Last short question answers, how can browning of the cut surface of the some fruits and vegetables be prevented? It can be prevented by rubbing with the lemon juice or putting into the fresh water. So the browning of cut fruits can be prevented by rubbing lemon juice on the cut surface or by placing the cut fruit underwater to prevent contact with oxygen. So this was our short question answers. You can take a screenshot of this short question answers, all the 8 short question answers. Have you taken the screenshot of all the 8 question answers? Now can we move towards the long question answers? Okay, so now we are moving towards the long question answers. Have you taken a screenshot? Very good. Now we are moving towards the long question answers. You can see in the long question answer, first one, explain with the help of example difference between an atom and molecule. So you have to write the define of atom. An atom is the smallest particle of an element that shows all the properties of the element. An atom may or may not have independent existence. For example, a molecule of oxygen or nitrogen gas contains 2 atoms. But if we talk about the molecule, a molecule is the smallest particle of an element or a compound that is capable of independent existence and has the properties of that element or compound. A molecule of an element may contain one or more atoms of the same kind. For example, the element helium is one atom molecule, while an oxygen gas molecule is formed of 2 oxygen atoms. A molecule of a compound contains 2 or more atoms of different elements. For example, carbon dioxide, sodium hydroxide. So this was the first long answer. Second, list 3 main properties of all compounds. So here there is a 3 main properties of all compounds, right? The main properties of all compounds are, you can take a screenshot of all these 3 points. Are you able to take a screenshot? Very good. After then, third one is balance the chemical reaction. How you will balance? Calcium plus oxygen is equal to calcium oxide. So calcium Ca plus O2 is equal to CaO. After then you have to balance 2Ca plus O2 is equal to 2Ca. Aluminium plus chlorine, aluminium chloride. So 2Al plus 3Cl2 is equal to 2AlCl3. After then, physical changes involved means you have to just define a physical change and the list, the characteristics, give three examples of physical changes. You can take the screenshot of this, the fourth one. Physical changes involve the change only in the physical properties of the substances and no new substances formed. What are the characteristics of physical? You can see a physical changes characteristics. It affects only the physical properties such as shape, size and state. The nature of the substance before and after change, after the change remains the same. No new substance is formed and it can be reversed or irreversible. So this was our physical change. Melting of ice, powdering of sugar and melting of wax are the three examples. Fifth one, experiment to get crystals. Here it is a very good experiment. You can just take a screenshot. You can write these examples or experiment one. Sixth one, what is chemical change? And list the characteristics, give three examples of chemical change. Just like physical changes, changes that involve the formation of new substance are called chemical changes. The characteristics of chemical changes are, there may be change in color, evolution of gas or effervescence may be observed, a precipitate may be formed, heat may be given out or absorbed. Burning of paper, curdling of milk and cooking of food are the examples of chemical changes. Now seventh one, what is rusting of iron? It's a very chemical change when the iron reacts with oxygen and atmospheric moisture to form iron oxide. To prevent rusting, what we do? We surface can be coated with oil, grease or paint, or it can be coated with another metal like zinc or chromium, that is called galvanization. Right? The last two question, 8 and 9, you can see here. Eighth one is, describe an experiment to prove that water and air is needed for rusting an iron. Already it is explained in the chapter and I had explained you also. You can just take a screenshot and write this answer. Ninth one is, explain with an experiment that what happens when iron nails are dropped into a solution of copper sulfate. So as you get all the answers of this chapter, you can write all these answers in your notebook. Each and every chapter's answer must be written in your notebook. Got it? So I hope that, see, first of all take the screenshot of 8th one. Have you taken? Now take the screenshot of 9th one. After taking the screenshot of 9th one, write these answers in your notebook. If you are having any type of doubt, then please drop your doubt into the comment box section so I can understand that your doubt is not clear. So first of all, I hope that all of you have written all the question answers. If you have not written, then please go at my channel. You are not getting the videos of 7th standard, so what you have to do, you have to just open my channel. And after opening my channel, you have to just go in the playlist option. In the playlist, class 7 science, you will get each and every video, whatever the video I have taught you. Every videos are uploaded on that. After that, you can write question answers also. Whenever you feel that I should write, now I am having a study time, so you can write that time also question answers. And please don't go outside nowadays, because it's a summer vacation. I can understand this is the last video class, so you should think that now we should enjoy, we should go outside, we should go for a tour. But since you know very well, all over the globe there is a very big critical situation right now, so we must follow the guidelines as the government is giving. We must stay at home, we must stay safe. Okay, I hope all of you have liked the videos, whatever I have taught you in the online session, and you have enjoyed. If you have thought that, yeah, sir should go ahead, sir should not stop, sir should make videos, we can learn anytime, whenever we feel. So you have to do what? You have to just press the bell icon and you have to like and subscribe the channel. You should motivate me, definitely I will make more and more videos for you. As I'll make more videos, you will get all the notifications. As you get the notifications, you can just go through it. Okay students, I hope the journey of this online classes now finish. Now stay at home. Take rest, stay at home, be safe and don't go outside. That's all for today. Thank you very much for interacting this online video session. Thank you very much. Don't forget to like and subscribe.